Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will explain how to group resources in the Vue Scheduler layout, in both the calendar and timeline views. I will also discuss the other advanced grouping options available in the Syncfusion Vue Scheduler. Here, if you look at this room scheduler, the timeline view has multiple resources grouped, where each row represents a resource. The appointments of each resource are displayed on its row. Now, I will show you how to group resources in the scheduler layout. First, I open an existing Vue application where I have already configured the resource data for the Vue scheduler. If you are new to adding resource data and appointments to the Vue scheduler, please watch the previous video and then come back to this one. Now, I run this example using the command npm run serve. Look at the scheduler output here, where you can see the resource appointments using different colors. Next, I will show you how to group the single-level resources in this scheduler layout. To do so, I will define a variable groupResource and assign the value tasks within this resources property. This string is nothing but the unique resource name that are assigned to each resource within the eResource tag to identify them among the other resource collections. I assign this variable to the group property inside the scheduler code. When you look at the output here, you can see each resource occupying its own space within the same scheduler layout, and the appointments of each resource are grouped accordingly in their own space. I have shown you how to define a single-level resource hierarchy, but with the Syncfusion Vue scheduler, you can display n levels of resources by establishing parent-child relationships. Now, I will show you how to group multi-level resources. To add another resource, first, I add a variable named resource data source and assign an array of objects with the fields person ID, person name, and color. Second, I will define one more eResource tag and assign this variable resource data source to the data source property. While defining the second level resource collection, the data source for this second level should be provided with an additional group ID field that maps with its predecessor data's exact ID value. Therefore, let me define one more field, task group ID, inside this resource data source and assign appropriate values to it. I assign this task group ID to the group ID field property of this resource. This group ID field will help us map the particular resource under its predecessor data and help the scheduler understand that it is the child data belonging to this parent resource. So, when I provide the value 1 for this group ID field, it means that this is a child resource to the resource in the first level that has the ID 1. Now, based on the second level resource data source, John will be mapped under development, Steve and James will be mapped under testing, as both these resources match the ID value 2. Now, how will we relate the resources with appointment objects when using multiple levels of resources? Here, you can see the group ID field mapped to the first level resource of the scheduler. So, to map the second level resource of the scheduler, let me define a field, resource ID, with an appropriate value inside the data source property. In my previous video on multiple resources, I explained resource fields, so now, I define those fields in the resource collection. I will define the properties, field, title, name, text field, ID field, and color field with appropriate values inside the eResource tag. Next comes the allow multiple property, for which I provide the value true. By setting the value to true, you can select multiple resources in the editor window. Finally, I need to pass this newly added name field value to the resources property. Now, when you look at the scheduler, you can see that the resources are grouped in two levels. At the first level, you can see development and testing, and at the second level, you can see the resources John, Steve, and James. Notice that in the first level, the support resource is missing. This is because, when you define two levels of resources, if your second level doesn't have any mapping to the resources in the first level, then it will be automatically truncated from the layout. Next, I will show you how to group the resources hierarchically, regardless of the resource ID mapped in the resource collection. Before proceeding further, I would like to explain this more clearly. Look at this scheduler component. Each resource in the second level is mapped under each item of the first level resource collection. To achieve this, I need to set the by group ID option to false inside the group property. Then, remove the Group ID field property from the second level resource collection. You can see Scheduler component, the resources are grouped hierarchically regardless of the resource ID mapping in the resource collection. Have a look at the appointments grouped under their resources. Whenever you have multiple levels of grouping, the colors of the appointments are usually decided based on the colors assigned to the innermost level of resources. So, the colors assigned to John, Steve, and James will be reflected on the appointments now. The important note here is the order of the resource names that you pass to this resource property. The resources will be grouped in the scheduler layout based on this order. Here, the first resource name acts as a parent, and the second resource name acts as a child, that is mapped under the parent resource. Next, I will show you how to group the resources based on date. To group the resources based on date, I just need to set the by date option to true within the group property. Then, I will remove the by group ID property and add group ID field property with an appropriate value. Now, you can see under each of these dates that the resources are grouped with their individual spaces. So far, we have seen resource grouping in calendar views, so let's see the group layout in a timeline view, where you can see the resources and their relevant appointments as individual rows. In this video, we have seen how to group multiple resources in the Vue Scheduler. We have also seen how to group the resources based on dates. If you would like to see a working example of this, you can download one from the GitHub link provided in the description for this video. I have also provided a link where you can see if you are eligible for our community license, which would grant you a free license key to use all our Vue products. If you find this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thank you for watching and stay tuned to see what's next.